Hey everyone here from Tunnel Vision TV, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you guys how to create a cutout cardboard animation in After Effects like the one you're seeing now. So first of all, you can see the cardboard texture, and for that you just simply go to Google and search for something like cardboard paper, find a texture that you like, download the picture and just bring that file into After Effects. Alright, so I'm going to create a new composition. Just click on new comp, and I'm going to set mine to full HD 1920 by 1080, and then I'm going to set the frame rate down to 15. And the reason I'm setting it to 15 is to get that stop motion effect. You can obviously set this to either 25 or 30 if you want a smoother animation, but for this tutorial I'm going to stick to 15, and then I'm going to set the duration to 10 seconds. Then you click on OK. Right, let's just rename that comp. So I'm just going to call it animation. So this comp 1, I'm just going to press enter and then type animation. And then I've got my cardboard texture, that's this one here, this JPEG. And I'm going to simply drag that into my new comp, and you'll see it's going to bring it into my composition. And then first I'm going to create the grass that you saw in the previous scene. So I'm going to select the pen tool, and I'm simply just going to click and draw like something like this. That's going to be the grass. Just close it down. And then I'm going to pre-compose this. So I'm going to right click on this, and then I'm going to select pre-compose, and then I'm going to give it a name. So I'm going to call this grass, and then just click on move all attributes into the new composition. Cool, then you click on OK, and then I'm going to go into that comp. So I'm going to double click on that comp, and then I'm going to tint it. So I'm going to right click on this layer, go to effects, go to color correction, and then go to tint, and then I'm going to tint it green. So map white, I'm just going to click on this white, and then just choose a color here. So I'm going to set this to green, click on OK, and then I'm going to go back to my previous comp, which is animation. So I'm just going to go ahead and close this example animation right here. So I'm going to go back to animation, and then you can scale it up. So you can just click one of these handles, holding shift, and then just drag it out. Or you can click on this layer, press S for scale, and then you can just scale it up. So another thing that you can do is if you go into this composition, and as you can see currently, this comp, if I go back to animation, if I scale it down, you can see the comp is a lot larger than the actual piece that we're working with. So if we go back into the grass comp, then you can click on this region of interest, and then just drag a box around the area that you're working with, and then you go to composition right at the top, and then you click on crop comp to region of interest, and that's just going to make that comp smaller. So now if we go back to animation, you've got that area that you're working with, and if you scale it up, you've got these handles that's really close to that area. So I'm going to click and hold in shift, and I'm going to scale it up, and then I'm going to move it into position, something like that. Alright, next I want to create my background. So I'm going to go back to my project, and I'm going to drag the cardboard into this comp again, and this time I'm going to put it below the grass because I want my background to be below or behind the grass. And then I'm going to pre-compose this layer as well. So I'm going to right click on that and go to pre-compose, and I'm going to call this one background, or just BG. And then remember to select move all attributes into the new composition, click on OK, and then I'm going to go into that comp. So I'm going to double click on background, and then I'm going to tint it. So I'm going to right click on it, go to effect, go to color correction, go to tint, and then I'm going to set this to like a light blue. So map white, click on the white, and I'm just going to set this to something like that, click on OK, and then I'm going to go back to my animation comp. Okay, then I'm going to scale it up. So I'm going to press S on the keyboard and just scale it up so it's filling the comp area. You can move it up if you want to, something like that. All right, next we're going to create our sun. So I'm going to go back into my project, and I'm going to bring in my cardboard texture once more, and this time I'm going to put it in between the grass and the background, because I want the sun to actually come out behind the grass, but it's going to be in front of the blue sky. Alright, so with that texture selected, you can either go into your shapes, you can use ellipse tool or any of these, but I'm going to select the pen tool, and I'm just going to draw a very rough looking circle, which will be the sun, something like that. Right, I'm going to adjust these points, okay, something like that, and then I'm going to pre-compose it. So right click, pre-compose, and I'm going to call this sun, and move all attributes, then OK. Go into that comp, then I'm going to tint it and set the white to yellow, and then click on OK, and then go back to my animation layer. Alright, so for the sun layer I want to resize the comp, so I'm going to go into sun again, and then I'm going to click on this region of interest, click on that and just drag a box around the sun like that. And then we're going to go to composition and then crop comp to region of interest. So I'm just going to make it small. So if I go back to my animation layer, then you've got these handles. That's just a lot closer to the object that you're working with. So I'm going to undo that, and now you can literally just go ahead and you can move it around. So I'm going to set the sun to start behind the grass, somewhere around there. And then I want to animate the position. So on this layer, I'm going to press P for position, and then I'm going to set a keyframe. So I'm going to click on the stopwatch, and then I'm going to go forward to around 2 seconds. And then I'm simply just going to click and drag to create a new keyframe. I want it to end there. And then you can use these Bezier handles. Just click and drag to set a curve, or to create a curve like that. And now if we go back and play this through, you'll see that the sun will actually rise like that. Okay, so next we're going to create the giraffe. Now, I'm not really good at drawing, so I'm going to cheat a little bit. So I'm going to bring this giraffe.png in to my comp, and this is just a PNG that I downloaded off Google. You can obviously download anything you want and you can trace it. And then I'm going to scale it down. So we're basically going to trace this giraffe with our cardboard texture. Alright, so now I'm going to hide all my other layers so I don't see the background and the sun and all of that. So I've got my giraffe there, and then I'm going to bring in my cardboard and I'm going to place it above the giraffe. And then I'm going to set the opacity on the texture so I can see through it. So with that texture selected, I'm going to press T on the keyboard, and then I'm just going to bring down the opacity to around 60%. That's fine, so I can see the image in the background that we're going to trace. And then I'm going to zoom in a bit, so I'm going to zoom into about 200%, and just hold in space if you want to just pan around the image. So I'm going to start here at the top, and then make sure that you're on the texture layer, and I'm going to click on the pen tool, and then I'm just going to roto around that image. So I'm basically just going to click, and I'm going to click and drag and just create a mask or a roto around that image. So I'm just going to quickly fast forward through this. Okay, then I'm going to zoom out again. So I'm going to select fit up to 100%, and then I'm going to delete my giraffe.png, the image that we traced. So I'm just going to remove that, and then I'm going to set the opacity on this layer back to 100. So I'm just going to drag that up to 100. And then I'm going to pre-compose this giraffe. So I'm going to right click on it, pre-compose, and I'm going to call it giraffe. Alright, then I can switch on my grass, sun and background again. And then I'm going to go into my giraffe comp, so just double click on that. Alright, you can move it around here. And then I'm going to set my region of interest. So I'm just going to click on this block, and then I'm just going to draw a box around it. Now I'm going to leave some space here at the front because I want to add some animation to the neck, which I will show you in a bit. So just leave a little space here, and then I'm going to go to composition and then crop comp to region of interest. Alright, so then if I go back to my animation comp, I've got my giraffe in there. And then we're going to add a simple animation of the giraffe just walking through the scene. So I'm going to show you two ways to animate this giraffe. So the first one, I'm going to place him off screen like that. And then I'm going to select my layer, press P on the keyboard for position, click on the stopwatch, and then I'm going to go forward to around 4 seconds. And then I'm just going to drag this giraffe forward, something like that, to this side of the screen. And then obviously it's going to create a new keyframe on that side as well. So now if I play through this, you'll see that there's a smooth kind of animation of the giraffe just moving across the screen. So if you want to create more of a stop motion animation, then we're going to do it frame by frame. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to delete this last keyframe on 4 seconds, and then we're going to create each keyframe separately. So on your keyboard, I'm going to use page up and page down to move forward and backwards. So page down is move forward one frame, and page up is move backwards one frame. So I'm going to go page down, and then I'm going to bring in the giraffe. So just move him in slightly, and then press page down again to go to the next frame. Move him slightly, then page down again, move him a bit forward, page down, and so forth. So I'm basically just pressing page down on the keyboard, moving him slightly forward, and then page down again. So if you do this, then you're going to get more of a stop motion, kind of a jagged animation. So I'll show you in a bit if I just run through this. Okay, so if I play through this, you'll see it's got a more of a stop motion feel to it. Okay, now I'm going to add some details to the giraffe. So I'm going to go into my giraffe comp, double click on that comp, and I see there's a shape layer here that we can delete. Don't know what that's doing there. All right, so what I want to do here is I want to split this into two layers. I want to split the body into one layer, and then I want to split the neck and the head into a separate layer so that I can animate them independently. So I'm going to duplicate this layer. So I'm going to click on this layer to select it, and then I'm going to go to edit and duplicate, or you can use the shortcut command D. All right, so I'm just going to rename them. So the top one I'm going to rename neck, and the bottom one I'm going to rename body. All right, so I'm going to hide my neck. So on the body layer, I'm simply going to click on it, and then I'm going to delete some of these points that I created when I did the tracing. So you can literally just click and drag, delete some of them like that. Okay, so that's our body, and then we're going to hide the body and show the neck, and then I'm going to delete some of these points at the bottom. So I'm literally going to delete all of those ones and all of those ones. So now I've got the neck separate and we've got the body separate. So now I want to place the neck behind the body, okay, because if we rotate the neck, it should actually be on the far side of the body. Okay, next we want to change the pivot point of the neck. So by default, the pivot point is kind of in the center of the object. So if I rotate it, you'll see it's almost right, but as you can see, it's not perfect. So I'm just going to undo that. So to move the pivot point, you can click on this icon here at the top. It's called pan behind. And then I can click and drag this little X or this crosshair just to the area that you want to place your pivot. And then we're going to go into rotation. So on your keyboard, just press R for rotation. And if we rotate it now, you can see it's slightly better. But I'm going to move it down. So just with that neck layer selected, I'm just going to move it down with my arrow keys. And now if I rotate it, you can see that is looking a little bit better. Alright, so now before we add our animation here inside this comp, I'm going to go back to my animation layer. Alright, so inside the animation comp, let's say we want to add the neck animation at around 2 seconds. Now we can see that our walking animation is fairly quick. It only lasts up to about 2 seconds. So if I play this back, you'll see 1, 2, and then he's off the screen. So first of all, I want to extend this animation. Now an easy way to do that, you highlight and select all your keyframes. And then you hold an Alt on the keyboard and you click and drag on the last one, and it will actually just extend those keyframes for you. So I'm going to extend it up to around 6 seconds. So now if we play it back, you'll see it's going to be a lot slower, something like that. That's good. And now let's say we want to add some animation at around 2 seconds. So I'm going to place my play it at around 2 seconds, and then we're going to go into my giraffe comp. So just double click on the giraffe comp, and that play it will stay in that area where you actually placed it in the main comp. And now we can add that animation to the neck. So on the neck layer, I'm going to expand rotation again, so R on the keyboard, and then I'm going to click on the stopwatch to create a keyframe, and then I'm going to go forward a couple of frames, and I'm going to increase the rotation amount to, let's say, to around there, and then I'm going to go forward a couple of frames again, and I'm going to bring this back to zero. So now if we scrub over this, you'll see you've got that animation. And before I forget, let's tint our giraffe. So I'm going to click on the body, and I'm going to go to effect and color correction and tint, and let's tint him a slight orange. Okay, and now I want to tint his neck the exact same color. So I'm going to go to body, and I'm going to click on that tint effect, and I'm going to copy it, command C, or you can go to edit and copy. And then I'm going to go to my neck layer and I'm going to paste it, command V, or you can go to edit and paste. Right, so we've got the same color there. And so if I scrub through this, we've got the animation here inside this giraffe comp. And now if I go back to the animation comp and I play this back, you'll see that that animation should happen around 2 seconds. There we go. And it's going to move over. All right, so next we want to add some details to the giraffe. So for this tutorial, I'm just going to create a very basic eye. So I'm going to go into the giraffe comp again. So I'm going to bring in my cardboard again for the eye. So I'm going to drag it right on top. And then I'm just going to create, I'm going to zoom in here to about 200%. And then with the pen tool, I'm just going to click and drag and create a eye, something like that. Okay, we can always adjust it. Okay, and then I'm going to tint it. So right click, effect, go to color correction, tint. And I'm just going to tint it black. So this white, or like a very dark gray, something like that. Okay, so I'm just going to zoom out, and then I'm going to rename my eye. So just click on that layer, press enter, and then just type in eye, and then we're going to move it into position. So I've got that layer selected, and with my arrow keys you can hold in shift to just make it move a little bit faster. Okay, something like that. That's looking cool. And now you're gonna have this problem where you've got this animation on the neck. So if I scrub through this, you're gonna see that the eye will actually stay there and it's not really following that animation. Now it's really easy to fix that. Simply what we need to do is we need to link the eye to the neck. So on that eye layer, you see you've got this little whip or this little parent, and just click and drag that to the neck because we want to attach it to the neck, and then you will see that the eye will actually stick to the neck. As simple as that. Alright, so let's go back to our animation comp, and if I play through this, you'll see that we've got the giraffe with the neck animation, and you can see the eye is sticking nicely to the head. Alright, so what I want to do next is add a drop shadow to some of these objects just to make it look more like a cutout animation. Alright, so on the giraffe layer, I'm going to right click and then go to effect, go to perspective, and then go to drop shadow. Okay, so as you can see, it's adding a nice drop shadow, and we're just going to change some of these parameters. So I'm going to set the opacity to 100, and then we're going to set the softness. I'm just going to increase that to around 40, 50. That's looking good. You can also change the distance here, but I think 5 is looking alright. And now I just want to copy and paste that shadow across all my other objects. So I'm going to select that shadow, I'm going to copy it, Command C, go to my sun and paste it there. And we don't really have to do it on the background because you can't see the shadow of the or the edges of the background. And we can do it on the grass. So I'm going to select grass, paste it, and there you can see we've got a bit of a shadow on the grass as well. Okay, I'm just going to trim down my comp so it's only showing this area. It's only using those amount of frames. And let's play through this and see how it looks like. So you can see you've got the nice shadows. It just makes it look more like a cutout animation than a normal digital animation. And that's how easy it is to create cardboard cutout animations using After Effects. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Click on that like button if you did, and also remember to click on that subscribe button to be notified of new weekly tutorials. Thanks for watching. Cheers, bye.